Hello, everybody. Good morning, good day, good evening, good night. Welcome to our seminar. And I'm very pleased to present our speaker for today. It's Professor Lyudmila Sabinina from Autonomous University of Morelos State, Mexico. And she will speak on Burnside problems in the theory of loops. Please. You can start, Lyudmila.
Thank you. I would like to start by thanking the organizers for the invitation to this virtual seminar. Okay. What? You can see here in the outline of my talk, I will begin my talk with some historical facts about the Burnside problem in the theory of groups. After this, I will tell about Burnside problem for Mouffant groups. Then I would like to give you an overview about some Burnside type problems for other important varieties of loops. I will continue by telling about the group with triality as a tool for studying Mouffant loops. And I will give a sketch of our proof, of the proof of our main theorem in the end. The Burnside problem appeared in the work of British mathematician William Burnside in 1902 in his studies of group. It became one of the influential questions in group theory during the 20th century. There are different variants of the Burnside problems, starting with the general Burnside problem. Is it true that a finitely generated periodic group is finite, followed by the ordinary or bounded Burnside problem? Is it true that a finitely generated group of exponent n is finite? There were obtained positive solutions in the particular cases for all number of generators. Burnside in 1902 solved ordinary Burnside problem for n equals 3. And you see the estimation. Sanov in 1940 solved for n equals 4. And Marshall Hall in 1988 solved for n equals 6. Till now, there are no positive solutions for n equals 5 or n more than 6 are known. Positive solutions of general Burnside problem are known for some classes. First, Burnside in 1905 solved ordinary Burnside problem for linear periodic groups, and then Schur solved it for general Burnside problem. And Otto Schmidt in 1945 solved general Burnside problem in the class of solvable periodic groups. Till 1964, the general Burnside problem was open until Evgeny Golod got a negative solution for this, for general Burnside problem. He constructed a series of finitely generated infinite p groups for an arbitrary p. Ordinary Burnside problem also has negative solution. Novikov and Adyan in 1968, using complicated combinatoric methods, constructed a finitely generated infinite group of odd exponent n greater than 4381. Later, Adian in 1975 improved this estimation to odd exponent n greater than 665. Adian passed away last month on 5th of May. We commemorated him in our seminars. His contributions to the solving of the Burnside problem was significant. Later in 1982, Ольшанский, who by the way was my supervisor at Moscow State University, using an absolutely different approach, obtained the negative solution of an ordinary Burnside problem. With the work of Sergei Ivanov, also the negative solution of ordinary Burnside problem, an even exponent was obtained. This problem, is it true that for each m and n, there are only finitely many finite m-generated groups of exponent n? This problem was formulated in 30s, and in 50s, Virgil Magnus named this problem as a restricted Burnside problem. Kostrykin found the positive solution for the prime exponent. Using Hall-Higman reduction theorem in 1956 and classification of simple groups, Zelmanov completely solved a positively restricted Burnside problem for the case of arbitrary exponent. He received the Fields Medal for this work. In the same article, where they gave the reduction theorem, Philip Hall and Graham Higman found the estimation of the finite group of M generators of exponent 6. With this, I'm finishing the overview of the most important milestones of the history of the Burnside problem in group theory. And now I will tell you about quasigroups and loops. Let L be a set endowed with a binary operation. L is a quasigroup if the left translation and right translation are bijections for every element of loop. Multiplication group is a group generated by all left and right translations. The quasigroups, quasigroup L is a loop if there exists a two-sided neutral element 1. Inner mapping group, int of L, is a subgroup of multiplication group of loop such that all elements of all inner mappings fix the neutral element. As usual, a normal subloop is a kernel of loop homomorphism. A subloop is normal if and only if it is invariant under inner mappings. A loop L called automorphic if all inner mappings are automorphisms. The center of loops of loop L is a abelian group, subgroup consists of all elements of loop which associate and commute with all elements of loop. By definition, abelian group is centrally nilpotent of class 1. A loop L is a centrally nilpotent of class N if the factor L over center of L is centrally nilpotent of class N minus 1. Analogously, abelian group is solvable of class 1. A loop L is solvable of class N if there exists an abelian normal subgroup N of L such that the factor L over N is solvable of class N minus 1. As usual, metabelian loop of is solvable of class 2. Now I will give a definition of Mouffant loop. There are different definitions of Mouffant loop. And here we will give one of them. the Mouffant loop is defined by two identities, left and right ball identities. By ball loop, we mean one of these identities, either right or left. Ball loop with identity automorphic inverse identity is called a Bragg loop. The intersection of the variety of Mouffant loops and the variety of Bragg loops is a variety of commutative Mouffant loops. By the way, ball loops with commutativity is a commutative Mouffant loop. Mouffant loops is the most known class of loops. Were introduced by Ruth Mouffant in the 30s. The units of alternative algebra form examples of Mouffant loops. The base elements of the algebra of actonians generate a Mouffant loop of 16 elements. Mouffant has shown the following famous theorem. Let U be a Mouffant loop, then elements, if elements A, B, C from U associate, then these elements generate a subgroup of U. As a corollary of Mouffant theorem, one can get the property of diassociativity. It means that every two elements of Mouffant loop generate a subgroup of U. Diassociative loops form a variety. The number of this variety is infinite. As the first result of Birdseye problem for Mouffant loops, one can consider the following fact. For commutative Mouffant loops, the restricted Birdseye problem has a positive solution. This fact is a corollary of Bragg-Slaby theorem. In comparison with groups, the theory of loops is a less popular subject. So in this part of my talk, I will give explicit references like this. In his book, Bragg called this statement Slaby theorem. Nowadays, it is known as Bragg-Slaby theorem or just Bragg theorem. In his book, Bragg proved his famous theorem on the central nilpotency of commutative Mouffant loop of finite rank. According to Bragg-Slaby theorem, the index of central nilpotency of any commutative Mouffant loop with n generators does not exceed n minus 1. Thus, for commutative Mouffant loops, there is a positive non-trivial solution of ordinary Birdseye problem for Mouffant loops. We have one trivial case for p equal 2, since Mouffant loops of exponent 2 are abelian groups. We hope that all finitely generated Mouffant loops of exponent 4 and of exponent 6 are finite. It is remarkable that Bragg theorem appeared in the same period of time when very important results in group theory were published, which we already cited. Hall-Higman reduction theorem, Kostrikin theorem, Marshall-Holt solved positively ordinary Bersite problem for n equals 6. And then relatively soon appears the theorem of Golod and Novikov-Adjan. I would like to quote Pchelentsev about this theory. In his monograph, Manin noted that Bragg's approach to proof is based on a very involved and ingenious inductive process uses hundreds of non-associative identities. In this book, a new approach to the investigation of commutative Mouffon clubs was suggested. Developing Manin's ideas and using the technique of nilpotent groups, Smith proved in 1978 that concerning the index of central nilpotency is sharp. And here the references of book of Manin and article for Smith. Next step in this story is Grishkov-Nagy theorem. For Mouffon clubs of prime exponent, the positive solution of restricted Bersite problem was proved by Grishkov if P doesn't not equal to 3. And for Gabor-Nagy, for P equals 3. It is analog of theorem of Kostrikin for groups. The method of the proof of Grishkov was based on the construction of Maltsev algebras using Mouffon clubs, for which it was considered the Zassenhaus filtration. We will speak about Zassenhaus filtration later. And here the references of articles of Grishkov and Nagy. Nagy used the modification of Mouffon club operation. He reduced the situation to commutative Mouffon club. Let L be a K-generated Mouffon club of exponent 3, then the loop with this new operation can be embedded in a K plus 1 generated commutative Mouffon club of exponent 3. This way, it was solved also the ordinary Bersite problem for Mouffon club in the case N equals 3. As for group, it was done by Bersite. As a next result on restricted Bersite problem and the variety of Mouffon clubs, one can consider the following theory. For automorphic Mouffon clubs, the restricted Bersite problem has a positive solution. Automorphic Mouffon clubs, the variety of automorphic Mouffon clubs includes the commutative Mouffon clubs. It was our first work with Peter Plaumann. Unfortunately, Peter Plaumann left us recently in this spring on April 14. I would like to tell you about one episode which Peter Plaumann told me. Peter appreciates the book Abstract Harmonic Analysis by Hewitt and Ross. Once Peter met Hewitt and praised his book. Hewitt replied that the secret to writing a good books or good articles is simple. One should choose the right co-author. I would want to say that Peter was a wonderful co-author. It was a great joy to work with him. He was an erudite person, very kind and patient, with his own special way of thinking and with great sense of humor. The friendship with him enriched many people, his students, his colleagues. Here we use the notion of nuclear nilpotency. Nuclear of loop is a group of elements of loop which associate with other elements of loops of loop. And nuclear nilpotency is similar to central nilpotency for commutative Mu-Fong loops. These two notions coincide. And the last here in this story, I will present our main theorem, which already is published in archive, and it can be formulated in the following way. There is a finite number of finite Mu-Fong loops M of M generators such that x to the n is 1 for all x from M, n is prime power for prime greater than 3. This part of my talk is inspired by one article of Evgeny Hukro, in which he proposed a similar program. We would like to discuss the problems in the theory of loops, which are related to Burnside problem. Let V be a variety of loops, and V of M and N be a set of all finite M-generated loops from V of exponent N. We're interested to understand, is V of Mn is finite set? Is the number of finite solvable or simple loops from V of M and N finite? Let L be a loop from V of M and P to the K, where P is prime. Is L centrally important? Let L be a loop from V of M and odd number. Is L solvable? It was the last question was the question of Burnside for groups posted him in 1897. Oy. Strange. Burnside type problems for some variety of loops. We will tell about Mu-Fong loops, about Ball and Bragg loops, about dissociative loops and automorphic loops. There are four different varieties of loops. And we will again begin with Mu-Fong loops. From a famous Fate-Thompson theorem, it is known that finite groups of odd order are solvable. George Clauberman extended Fate-Thompson theorem for Bragg and Mu-Fong loops using so-called one-half construction. This is a formula of a new operation, which converts Mu-Fong loop operation to Bragg loop operation for loops of odd order. And we have the theorem of Glauberman. Bragg loops and Mu-Fong loops of odd order are solvable. Where mentioned above the classification of simple groups played an important role in the solution of restricted Burnside problem for groups. For Mu-Fong loops, the classification of simple objects was completed by Liebig in 1987. First page found examples of finite simple Mouffon loops as following. We can consider loops of actonians of multiplicative loop M, which consists of element of actonian algebra over the field FQ, elements of norm one. Then we can take the factor M over center of M, and it is exactly page loop, simple Mouffon loop. Liebig proved that a finite simple Mouffon loop is either associative and hence is a finite simple group, or is isomorphic to one of the loops of page. For his proof, Liebig used the results of Doro. And here we have references of all authors, of all publications. In what follows, we will refer the first and the last article of this list when we will speak about the group with triality. Now we'll talk about Ball loops. Ball loops of exponent 2 turn out to be Bragg loops. Gabernach proved the existence of infinitely many finite 2-generated Bragg loops of exponent 2. His proof was based on the example of Kolb and Kreutzer. This way, the restricted Birsait problem for Bragg loops and hence for Ball loops has a negative solution for n equals p equals 2. It is interesting that for p greater than 2, this question is open. And here you see reference to the articles of Kolb and Kreutzer. This is their example. The formula in this page is known. Usually it was used in the plane of complex numbers in order to give an example of Bragg loops. And Kolb and Kreutzer used the field of characteristic 2, and Gabernach interpreted it to find a negative solution of restricted Birsait problem for Ball and Bragg loops. It was a long-standing problem, open problem in loop theory to find a simple Ball loops. In 2005, Aschbacher discussed the hypothesis of the existence of simple finite Ball loops of exponent 2. And Gabernach, using the ideas of Aschbacher, found infinitely many such examples. The minimal order of such example is 96. Now we switch to the variety of diassociative loops. In general, the knowledge of diassociative loops of exponent n doesn't equal to 2 is very little. Diassociative loops of exponent 2 are Steiner loops. They have relation with Steiner triples in combinatorics. The possible order of non-associative Steiner loops is 2 modulus 6 and 4 modulus 6. Let T be an order of loop. If T is equal 10, there is a smallest Steiner loop, and it is unique with this order. For order 14, there are 2 non-isomorphic Steiner loops. For order 16, there are 80 loops. And for order 20, the number of non-isomorphic Steiner loops is very big. It is of 11 digits. Most of them are simple. It is known that there exist infinitely many finite simple Steiner loops with three generators. And now we will consider the variety of automorphic loop. Automorphic loop appeared in the article of Bragg and Page in 1956. In the paper, loops whose inner mappings are automorphisms. Then during many years, there were no specific interest to this variety. In the beginning of this century, it was shown by Kenyon and other authors that the intersection of variety of dissociative loops and variety of automorphic loops is in variety of automorphic moving loops. About 10 years ago, the research in automorphic loops became broader. Even for commutative automorphic loops, restricted Bersite problem has negative solution. There exist examples of two-generated infinite metabolian commutative automorphic loop of exponent p. It is result of Grishkov, Raskazov, and Tikhovsky. And then we have theorem of Kenyon, Kunin, Phillips, and Tikhovsky. Finite automorphic loops of odd exponent are solvable. It was shown in this article, and in this article also examples of non-nilpotent finite automorphic loops of exponent p, even commutative if p is equal to, are given. But all finite commutative automorphic loops of prime power when p is greater than 2 are nilpotent. In the article of Grishkov, Kenyon, and Nagy, they showed that for p equals 2, it will finite commutative automorphic loops of exponent 2 are solvable. For the non-commutative case, it is an open problem. Now we will tell about a link between loops and groups. In some sense, we can consider loops of groups by non-normal subgroups. Let G be a group and H be a subgroup of G. Let us fix a set B from G such that G is product of H and B, such that every element from group has unique form in this product. Then the set B admits a binary product which arrived from product of in group. Usually this product is not associative. Usually this B with this operation is not a loop, but in some under some special conditions is a loop. And now we will talk about a group with triality. Here we have a definition of group with triality. Group G with automorphisms rho and sigma, which form a group S3, and with identity of triality, is a group with triality. Let G be a group with triality and U this set. Then the subset U endorphed with the multiplication becomes a Mouffon group. Every Mouffon group U can be obtained in this way from a suitable group with reality, which is finite if U is finite. Moreover, if P is a prime number, then a finite P loop can be obtained from a finite P group with reality. First, the definition of Mouffon of group with reality appeared in the paper of Doro. And Doro defined Mouffon group, constructed Mouffon group from group with reality using the Baer construction. Which I told about before. Grishkov and Zavarnitsyn found the very nice formula of multiplication. This formula. In this article, it was found. Here we show how loops can help with information about groups with automorphisms. Derzeit type problems allow a natural generalization of the case when one has no information about the exponent of the whole group, but about some part of it. The most interesting situation is when the group G with some involution sigma is generated by the set G sigma, like it is shown here. Suppose that x to the n is equal 1, x from this set G sigma. What can be said about the group G? Is there a finite number of such finite group with m generators? In general case, the answer is negative for n equals 2. But one important case with a positive answer is known. Suppose that the group G additionally admits a third order automorphism rho, and identity of triality holds. Such groups are exactly groups with triality. And our main result can be restated. There is a finite number of finite groups with triality G of M generators, such that x to the n is equal 1, n is a prime power, p is greater than 3. Here the classical scheme, as it was used by Higman, Kostrykin, Zelmanov, from a group using Zossenhaus filtration, there exists order of elements of groups leads to some kind of linearization of angular identity in the corresponding Klee algebra. From this, it is possible to get the property of local nilpotency of Klee algebra. And together with finite number of generators, one can get the desired information of groups. For groups of prime power exponent, it was the most difficult part, which was resolved by Zelmanov. In our case, we start from Mouffon group A, then we consider the corresponding minimal group with reality, then we are studying the corresponding Klee algebra with reality. Then, using the results of Michiev and Grishkov, we go to Maltsev algebra, and finally, with the help of Filipov theorem and the powerful technique developed by Zeliminov, we finish the proof of our main theorem. We recall here the description of Zassenhaus filtration of group G and the construction of correspondent Lie algebra over the field of order P. Here we introduce the operation of Lie algebra in the left side, and in the right side it is commutator of initial group. As we used Zassenhaus filtration, where we got p power of elements, we can obtain natural Lie p algebra. Here we recall the notion of restricted Lie algebra or Lie p algebra. The usual reference for this Lie p algebra is the Jacobson book Lie algebras. Since our Lie algebra appears from a group with triality, it inherits the identity of triality, but in linearized form. Then we get the following lemma. Let G be a group with triality, and let P be a prime number, then LPG is a Lie P algebra with triality. This lemma is natural. Not difficult. Here we have a definition of Maltsev algebra. It is a non-associative algebra which satisfies this identity. First is anti-commutative identity, and second is some generalization of Jacobi identity. And this lemma by this lemma we have the star operation of Maltsev algebra in the set of antisymmetric elements to respect to involution sigma. Here, as before, the construction of Maltsev algebra is realized on the set H, which is a set of antisymmetric elements with respect to involution sigma. Our first lemma tells us about the connections between the Lie algebra operation and star operation, Maltsev algebra operation. And the last lemma is important because it helps with control of generators of Maltsev algebra. Here the subspace H can be graded, and we expect that Maltsev algebra also will be graded. So, by the formula of multiplication and Mumfang loops, which constructed from groups with triality in the subset U, one can see that elements in Maltsev algebra, elements A to the K, and elements A to the K in the group with triality, it is the same element. This lemma asserts that two properties hold in the subset H. First property is angle identity, and second it is linearized angle identity, and it is in with respect to Lie algebra operation. The lemma which you have here says that two elements from subspace H are commute A and rho of A. Again, recall that our Lie algebra with triality constructed from a group with triality, which was constructed from a Mufang loop. And this example shows us that for arbitrary algebra with triality without this background of Mufang loop, this property is not necessarily valid. And now this proposition proposition says that finitely generated graded massive algebra, which are based these two properties of angle identity and linearized angle identity, is nilpotent and finite dimensional. Together with Filipov theorem and all results of Zelmanov, we get the positive solution of restricted Burnside problem of Mufang loops of prime power exponent such that a prime is greater than 3. With this, I finish my talk. Thank you.
Okay. Laura, questions, comments? Any questions or comments? No, no questions, no comments. So let us thank Professor Lyudmila again. To announce, remember that the next Thursday we have a talk by Agata Askarskaya from Bar Ilan University, Israel. And she will speak on group-like small constellation theory for rings. So we are waiting for all of you again the next Thursday. And now, thanks, Emila, to you. Thanks to all participants. Till the next time. Bye-bye.
Thank you.